Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For today's meditation, let's turn to the Psalm 130 and verse number 1. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my prayer. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Abba Father, we still our heart before you. Therefore, open our mind to understand your word in the power of your Spirit. Grant us with your grace to learn the truth from your word. Therefore, Holy Spirit, rest upon us. Holy Spirit, guide us. Holy Spirit, possess us. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Let me give you a brief introduction to this passage. We understand that the psalmist was living in times when he was all at sea. He cried out, indicating the time in his life when he could not pray, rather cry. He cried to God because he trusted in God, who had the power to deliver. Well, it is likened to a child who cries when the child is in need and turns to the parent. Well, a stage came in the life of the psalmist as well when he started to cry to God in his rock bottom situation. And what he faced was parallel to his emotions. The psalmist had the life of mixed emotions because on reading the psalm, we read a psalm that is full of rejoicing and some of the psalm that are filled with pain and sorrow, sensing that he had a time that he laughed and a time when he cried as well. Well, God brings in these set of emotions in our lives because he knows that we would turn to him. Now let us understand why God brings in such situations. Now let us understand the first point and the reason why God brings in such emotions. That is because God plans to condition us. Even before God leads us, God has already prepared a proposal or a blueprint of his plan for us, and he works accordingly. The proposal may include the package of struggles, failures, or even hardship. God brings in such situations in our lives because God has a purpose for which he is preparing us. Now, say for example, a sailor is first trained how to fight the storm than to sail a ship, because after training for the storm, sailing becomes much easier. In the same way, a firefighter is taught to carry heavy loads before being taught the technique of firefighting. Because in the event of fire, he has to rescue people and carry them on their shoulders to take them to a safer place. Tougher situations conditions us so that what follows after hard work and practice are the easier ones to handle. We know that when a contractor signs a contract to build an apartment or any structure, he will first set aside the expenses that would come under the head miscellaneous expenses. And that may include theft, that may include absence of labor, that might include strike that is unprecedented, that would even set aside expenses like bribing the officer. In the same way, when God has prepared a blueprint, he has also included a package of many times that we would grumble, the many times we would give up, and the many times we would lose hope. All hopes were gone when I lost my mom. I was so clueless. I did not know what to do, but God already prepared a blueprint that I would serve him as a priest. The second point and the reason why God brings in such emotions is because God strengthens us to mature. Now remember, God measured the depths even before we would cry in the deep, and God knew to what point we would reach the true rock bottom and the moment we would resort to crying. The depth moments are the times of no hope in life, being rejuvenated and all seems to be a mirage. We even reach so near to the desire that even that ends up into a mirage. In the path to achieve our bigger dreams, we all fail at some point when we know that all our dreams are tarnished. We cry on account of the repeated failures, disappointments, and hurtful moments. Now remember the two dying thieves. They turned to Jesus when they started to experience excruciating pain. The two thieves turned to God when pain was to the core. One complained by hurling insults and curses, and the other thief understood the abundance Jesus had at his command. It is in situation we turn to God to know who He is, rather what He can do. Ideally, a child fears when the light goes off in the dark. What they'll do? They cling on to their parents. If a child knows whom to turn to in the moment of fear, we, like the psalmist, will definitely turn to God. The child turns to the father because the child knows what the father will do. And likewise, we know what the Heavenly Father will do in times of fear and hopelessness. We fear when we have issues and complications coming our way. Once we come to that understanding, yes, my God will sort the issue, it is only then God starts working in our lives. God wants to find the maturity in us, which is the first step where God knows that we are leaning on Him. And that is what causes us to get rid of our fear. We all know that wine matures with age, and maturity comes with the passage of time. Dear friends, in my life as well, I came across situations, and every time I used to look at the situation and I pray, I do not know how God settled it. So, if I had a problem or a situation or a mountain in front of me, God solves that, but immediately there's another problem that creeps up. And when I think about it, God solves it, then another one creeps up. See, this is the kind of a struggle that I had gone through. But all I know is that in every situation that I faced, I always had God's hand in it. See, this is what happens when we are going through that journey with the Lord. Remember, even before we have stepped into that problem, God has already sorted out that issue. God has already made way for that. That is the promise that we have. See, we are not asking for silver or gold. Remember that. We are just asking for our issues to be sorted out. And that is where God honors us, because God knows that we are asking what is needed. The third point and the reason why God brings in such emotions is because God wants to infuse confidence. It is a moment in life when we are alone, abandoned, and living in fear. The psalmist too was struggling to experience the nearness of God. I remember when I was a kid, my parents used to take me to the park, and the moment I'm distracted, they hide themselves. And after I turn back not to find them, I start to cry. It is after a while they both come laughing and I realize they were playing a prank on me. The next time when they hid, I knew my parents were playing a prank. Therefore, I knew that though they are hiding, yet they are watching. I sat well composed, knowing that they would finally come to me. Another example I wanted to cite is the example of an infant who starts walking. And the infant will not cry as long as the infant sees the mother around. But the moment the mother is away, the infant starts crying. I remember once I had to go for a haircut. So I called the barber the previous night to know when the salon would be opened. To this he replied, 8:30 in the morning. I usually sit for prayers at 6. complete my daily practice of praying, meditation till 9:15. However, on that day I stepped out of my prayer room at 8:30 a.m. I took my book with me in which I write the messages I get through meditation and proceeded to the saloon. Unfortunately, I found the saloon closed. Now, usually what happens in such situation, I think to myself, this happens only with me. Every time I go out to find something, it never happens. On the contrary, this time I started to meditate on the verse. So, what I mean to say is, it is better to be like Mary than to be like Martha. Now, Mary chose to listen to Jesus, that is the word of God, than being worried like Martha. Jesus did not take away the worries of Mary. Rather, Mary found peace the moment she started to hear from Jesus. Had Mary joined Martha, she too would have been worried like Martha. We become worried when we listen to Satan, but when we turn to Jesus, we find peace even in the midst of chaos. I was wondering, had I not chosen to meditate, I would have been worried, and that was enough for me to brood the entire day with negative thinking. In our spiritual walk, we come to a stage when God wants us to cry, feel abandoned, fear, find enemies, even come to the point of no hope situation. It is only through past experiences we come to understand that God is always with us, because we have the Holy Spirit in us who keeps reminding and encouraging us. God wants us to believe in Him. That is the confidence that qualifies us to trust Him. If we are struggling yet to seek God, God observes how much we seek Him than giving up on Him. I would like to share a story of a man who was running a business and it faced severe losses. And eventually the man had to sell his properties and cars to continue running the business. Now, looking at the situation, the son asked the father, "Why are you still running the business when you are at loss? Why don't you shut the business?" The father smiled and replied, "My son, life can bring us many challenges and even push us down. But when we have hope, we can overcome any challenges." The son questioned, "How hope will help us?" The father answered, "Okay, let's go. I will show you." The father took him to a big well and asked his son to jump. The son shockingly replied, "Father, I don't know how to swim, so I cannot jump." But his father pushed him to the well and went into hiding. Son struggled and kept on trying to float for close to 5 minutes. And after some time, when he was about to get drowned, the father jumped, pulled him out of the well. The next day, the father again took his son to the well and asked him to jump again. The boy, with some hesitation, jumped into the well. Father again went into hiding. The boy again struggled to keep floating and he pushed harder. Time kept on running and even after 15 minutes, he was pushing himself. Then father came, pulled him out of the well. The father asked his son, "Why you were pushing harder than yesterday?" The son replied, "Yesterday, I was not knowing what to do when you pushed me into the well. And I was in fear that I would be drowned. But today, I knew that you will come and save me. And when I am about to be drowned, you will rescue me." Dear friends who are listening, may you always be reminded that we have the God who will never let us sink in our misery. Because though we feel God is hiding, yet we will be surprised to see a mighty hand delivering us from the water, especially when we are sinking. Always remember, dear church, if God is taking you to Rome, He will make you live as a Roman. That is the God we serve. It's not that if God takes us to Rome, we end up as beggars. No. God will enlarge us. He will make sure that all our needs are being met. Remember that we are children of God. And we will be given the same treatment as the King gives to His children. Now remember, dear church, even if we are in the depth as the psalmist was, and though we are surrounded by darkness, we are surrounded by walls from all the sides, but when we look up, there is light, which means we have a hope. We have a hope when we look up. And that's where God wants us to look at, so that we might see the hand of God reaching out to us to rescue us. So as usual, a reminder that Jesus is coming, and He's coming soon. The time of His coming is not known, but the coming of Jesus is real and true. God bless you all. Have a Christ-centered week. Love you all in Jesus' name. Amen.